Yo, what is happening, guys? Unspeakable Vlogs here. Today we're back and we're back with another reaction. And it is to Dax. I've been excited for this. Last song Dax released was Gotham. Fucking banger. Fucking loved it. This is called Joker Returns. So he released the song Joker. I can't remember how long it was. A while back. He was basically targeting like cyberbullying and all, and like, I don't know, it was a really cool video. I don't really want to get too much into it, but yeah, it was a really cool video, really dope song. Gotham was really good. And I think this is his last or second last track coming from the whole Gotham type of thing, like being the Joker and the mind state of the Joker. And how you said that Gotham is not, it's a mind state and a lifestyle and all. I think this is either the last or second last, but without further ado, I'm excited. So let's just jump right into this one, because I've been waiting, Dax. I've been waiting, so let's get it. Bullying kills. There we go. I reckon this is just how Dax sleeps, to be honest.
Oh my god.
I'm sick, but I already told you that once. That blood you saw last time wasn't fake, it's real, I do my own stunts. That gun had bullets, I just got lucky, I play Russian roulette for fun. That knife was trash, I got it replaced, it didn't cut deep, it was too blunt. That girl's still here, she's sucking my dick.
Oh my
I might have been wrong, she may be the one. We're not in love, but in 2021 I'm going to let her have my son, so we can post and fake happy while our real lives come undone and stay home and watch me run. But I don't want your sympathy. Fuck your help! Everyone's an expert on everyone else except their fucking selves. Last time that I made a song, I left a lot of shit on that shelf, cause I know you're too weak to hear the truth or care about how I felt. And oh, hi, comment section. Did you know your words describe you and not me? And bounce back, cause in life, we project our insecurities on people we wish we could be, while blinded by the fact that we're our own biggest, worst enemy.
Yo, before he gets in, I oh my god. Literally, that part has just got me hyped for, like, the rest of the song. Like, I really love Dax acting this Joker character. I really do. Like, it's just Gotham, the Joker and all. Dax plays it so well. Like, he does. When he raps, because, like, it's like in the Joker, you know, obviously he has his rapping and all, sounds normal, but he raps about serious shit, and then he does the Joker laugh, and he just, like, the way he motions, like, he's really good, not only lyrically, but he's really good video-wise. When it comes to performing in the video and making it interesting, he's really good. Like, even in his freestyles, he doesn't just stand there and rap, like, he has his hands all about the place, you know what I mean? He's really good for this, so I'm excited, so. Okay, I want to hear what you got to say next.
Yeah, you don't know me, you knew me. You thought Joker was a joke, that's just my life, this ain't no movie. You torment me and abuse me, hunt me, chase me and amuse me. I'm at war inside my mind, my ops are black, they hide at night. Like I'm playing Call of Duty, I'm depressed, but cancel culture causing me to say that loosely. Why do you judge if you're not Judy? You're not my friend, you're dead to me. After what you've done, I feel like Uzi. I'm done dealing with these groupies. When they see me, they see food, I feel like sushi. Oh, it's funny, right? Cause it's not happening to you. Size 13 men, there's no damn way you can walk in my shoes. Take this pain and do what I do. I'm making songs that people use to get through shit I can't get through all day. Laugh, hate, destroy, and constantly rid.
That's facts. He said, oh, it's funny because it ain't happening to you. You know, when people talk about this shit, about how they feel, their mental state, blah blah, people making fun of them, people commenting, hating on them, doing all this and that, going out of their way to just be an asshole. They all find it funny. Because they're not the ones taking it. You know, it's like nowadays, everybody wants their say, everybody wants to have their opinion on everything, which you're entitled to do. But people nowadays just view it as, I can say whatever I want to you and I'm fine. But when you say it to me, that's wrong. You can't do that. Like, people literally do that. They go, I'll say whatever I want to you and it's completely fine. I'm allowed to. But as soon as you literally say the littlest thing, they go, oh, well, now you're just a dickhead. Why did you say that? Now you're just making fun of me for that. And then they act the victim. So, like, he's right. It ain't funny. It's only funny, sorry, because it ain't happening to you. But if it was happening to you, you wouldn't be fucking laughing. So, I get you, Dex.
Ridicule, you guys are pitiful. You take my words and you twist them. That's why I don't want to do interviews. I told my mom I was suicidal and she cried in the scream. What the hell has got into you? I don't know, Mom. Maybe those people who laugh, hate, spin the truth, and pray you fail. And once you do, they start kicking you. Fuck. They try to put me in a hospital bed, diagnose me and stuff me with meds. All it ever did was fuck up my head. They anti-depress you until you're depressed again. And then you
That's
depend
facts.
On the pills that made you independent. What a shame.
when he said about the hero villain, somebody's idol, I'm assuming he's talking about, I'm not sure, but I'm assuming he's talking about from people's standpoints. And some people, no, everybody has their story. Some people's story, you're an asshole, you're the villain. Some people's story, you're the hero. You're their idol, you're the one, like, say, you help them through tough times, they look up to you, and then there's the other ones, it's like, oh no, you're an asshole, man. I'm assuming he's talking about from people's standpoints. So, to some of yous, I'm evil, I'm the villain. To some of yous, I'm nice, I'm your idol, blah, blah, blah. That's what I'm assuming he said.
Let me clarify and get this straight. I make songs that no one else can make, that millions love because they relate, then get half the recognition but twice the hate, then reinvest and do it all again.
Facts.
Quick for speed than anyone driving in my lane. Then I smile and wave, work and slave, talk to my fans every day. While you trolling, no need to take breaks to take the shit or masturbate, then claim my life's a piece of cake. Like you could somehow do it, even though we know you wouldn't, cause you're too goddamn afraid. Don't even join my circus this time, I'm not in the mood. Go listen to that mainstream music or whatever your friends think is cool. I'll sit here and play the fool while you drool and drown inside my tears that fill Olympic pools. Even Michael Phelps couldn't endure. Furthermore, I'm tired of drinking and waking up on that floor. Tired of living a life I cannot afford. Tired of living my life.
Okay.
People who never saw me as equal, who hate me and just try to ignore. No more, it's war, I'm evening this score. Killing everyone that walks through that door and tells me I need wings to soar. So let me take that knife and gun and stop pointing them at myself. I've heard enough, it's time for you to feel along with everyone else. Society needs sobriety, we put people down for notoriety. Love in public but destroy them privately. I didn't create an anxiety, tell me why love and don't get it.
Yo, what he said earlier where he goes, about how he speaks to his fans every day and shit, it's facts. He said that he speaks to his fans every day, and like, there's people that, like, they have fan bases, and everyone paints about, like, oh, they're such a nice person, but I don't give a fuck about their fan base. And then there's Dax over here. Like, I've seen artists do it before, you know, there's a lot of people who's very, like, you know, they're very thankful. KSI has shown many times he's thankful. Dax has, Tom McDonald has, Jordan Lucas, Eminem. Like, there's obviously a lot of them that just don't show it. A lot of them that do actually show how much they appreciate. Dax is one of them. He sits. I go into his live just to literally just be there and see what he's saying and all, see what's up. And he's just sitting there and answering questions. He always has energy. He's always there. That if you're feeling shit, you get in. He just has this pumped up energy. It pumps you up. You're like, hell yeah. But, like, he gives his fans the time, because they, without them, you know, he doesn't have his career. He is the talent, but he needs the eyes and people listen to him, and they give that to him, and he appreciates them. That's why I like that. Also, yeah, he also said, you love in public, but you destroy privately. There's a bunch of people that always say, oh, love everybody, spread positivity, be nice to everyone, respect everyone, which I agree with 100%, but then they'll talk shit about people behind their back. And I know too many goddamn people like this. They're always there. And they, in public, they want to be viewed as, oh, they're the ones that say love everybody. They're the ones that, they're like a leader. They're positive. And then behind their back, they'll be like, oh yeah, this guy, he's a dick because of this. And it's never a good reason, you know what I mean? So that's facts, you know, that there's too many people said love publicly and hate privately. It ain't, the person you are publicly does not describe who you are. The person you are behind closed doors describes who you are. Not publicly. Not when you're in the public eye. When you're alone, that's when you know who you are. Like,
oh, the irony. This was a poem I wrote in my diary, fighting demons deep inside of me. I feel alone, yet I'm constantly fighting for privacy, seeking truth while everyone I know lies to me. It's ironic because the people who knew me the best and support me until I finally made it. Now they want to fake it and act like they love me when I know they don't even like me.
Fuck you.
Slick. I remember the day, dude, fuck my bitch. I remember rejection after rejection and going home wanted to slip my wrist. I remember that coach who said I went shit, then took my fucking scholarship, and all the kids that used to bully me just because I didn't fit in. How did it feel? When you see me now, they say if you're alone and fall, it doesn't make a sound. What goes up must come down, unless you get a knife and cut a smile so you never frown.
You look nervous. Is it the scars? You want to know how I got them? Come here. Look at me. I said, look at me!
This is what I mean.
Can I hurt you?
This is exactly what I mean. He's good. He's a good performer. Suicide prevent. There you go. I think he did that in Joker, I'm pretty sure as well. Pretty sure in Joker he did that. At the end. No, the start. Was it the start? Pretty sure in Joker he posted them. I think it was at the start actually. He did post it in Joker. Yeah. I love Joker. That was sick. See, I like the way. There's only very few artists that talk about shit like this. Again, like literally the two. Whenever you say that talk about serious shit like this, like that I listen to the most, Dax and Tom McDonald, two ones that do this shit. And funny, they made a song together. But yeah, no. He said so many right things, like, you know, there's so many fake people that state this in public but aren't like that behind closed doors. They find it funny, they'll talk shit about you, but whenever it happens to them, you know, it's wrong. Like, they'll ridicule you, they'll say everything you do is wrong. No matter, even if you're trying to be the nice person, I've said this a million times, you will never be able to please everybody. And that is a fact. People who think that they can please every person on this planet, I'm sorry, but you're delusional, because you can't. You could be the nicest person, you could make all the money charity, you could cure a deadly disease like cancer, you could fucking do all of this. Somebody's going to hate on you because you're such a nice person. They'll actually hate on you. So I like the way Dax touched on this, though, when he was saying, he went into detail. It's very graphic, though. He went into detail about coming home and, like, contemplating it. And, like, I'm not, like, I don't really want to, like, get into it, but, like, getting the blade and, you know what I mean? Like, he really went into it, and I really like it. I really like it. This is my favorite music Dax does. The freestyles are cool. You know, the upbeat, like, the cool, like, lyrics. Like, you know, like, upbeat songs are cool. But when it's a song or an artist that talks about something and, like, has you listening, like, I want to vibe to the song. I want to be there like this, Bobs. But I also, if you can literally have me sitting there thinking, like, oh, shit, you know, he's a good point, and thinking, like, actual, like, thinking, then you've done your job 100%. So, as always, Dax, well fucking done. Because you did it again. And I will have to wait ages until he releases a new song. But I don't know if this is the last one in the Gotham Mind State, Joker Mind State. It's either the last or the second last, I'm pretty sure. But I'm sure he'll be live on Instagram in about 20 minutes after I literally stop recording here to tell us. But yes, as always, Dax, well done. Let me know what y'all think about this down in the comments. Let me know if there's any particular lines that y'all like, because I actually do really like to hear people's feedback and, like, just what they thought was good about the song, what their favorite part was. Like, I do read the comments, I do reply, like, I do want to hear that. Smash like button if you did enjoy. Smash subscribe button if you haven't yet already. I really do appreciate it. And, yeah, as always, yeah, hope y'all are thinking positive and testing negative. And hope you all are having an amazing day. I've been Unsputed, and I'll see you in the next one. So, peace.